Hello everyone, today on the channel we are going to make a new deck because it's Deck Academy. So let's go ahead and we don't actually know what deck we want to make. However, it's standard deck, so we're gonna take a look at our mythic rares and see what which color we can get in. We didn't make a deck with this angel, and we do have two of them actually. So yeah, let's make a life gain deck that can win with this. We could try to play mono white. So let's put in all these bad boys in. And let's go to our rares. These are just the mythic rares. See what else we can put in besides the lands. Sure, he likes to gain life. Who else would like to gain some life? So the key is to try to gain life. That's the key. And then we can win with the angel. Or yeah, we don't win with the angel. Actually, we don't have many enchantments, so Archons of Sun's Grace does not make much sense. This guy does though. And it would be nice to have some more removal, maybe four Shatter the Sky and a couple of Elspeth Conquers Death. So let's see this guy, he doesn't do much. We have 24 creatures, okay. So far so good. Let's play one on the inversion. And let's play Fabled Passage as usual. Because why not? And we need to change our lands. Our 18 flames. Get much better looking flames. Actually, Which one shall we get? Usually we use the Godzilla ones. But in this situation, I guess we can use... Wait, where are the Godzilla ones? Yeah, let's use the Zendikar planes. And we need to get some other lands actually. There's the planes. To get other other lands. Not Bonder's Enclave. Through Crawling Barrens would be also good. And I believe that is it. So let's see if this deck can actually do anything in standard. It's a bunch of creature, a bunch of removal, and yeah, try to win. We're gonna go and play a few games as usual, not in ranked, just unranked, because you have no idea how this deck's gonna do. But we might be able to win. We might have something here. God knows what people are playing in standard these days. Mono white life gain. That is how we roll these days. That is how we roll. Yeah, we'll keep this I mean, we got stuff happening on our side. What is the opponent doing? So, what does unranked standard look like these days? Or rather, what do we get paired up against? I don't think we need two of these crazy guys. The self meal deck. Well, we do need to draw more lands so we can cast our big boy. Getting there, at least we can start to put counters on this land. It's not gonna be an exciting matchup, that is for sure. They seem to be taking their sweet time as well, although they're not really playing a control deck. Let's throw these sleeping guys at them. What are they thinking about? Come on, we need to get going. This is not how life's supposed to work. Let's get this big boy out and hope they don't have a removal spell, which they probably have, but I mean there's nothing else we can do. They make us discard. We are drawing lands. We say we need to draw lands, now we need to stop drawing lands. But wow, feed the swarm. That's a removal spell if we ever saw one. Oh, we need to get rid of this thing, that's for sure. That is for sure. We definitely don't want them drawing extra cards. Or scrying. Although they are already up in the Kroxa. They can bring back one Kroxa already, which is unfortunate. Yeah, we should actually play Maze Mind Tome. We should revise this deck because we literally have no card draw and we're basically down to like nothing now. Because we're gonna have to discard one of our Shatter the Sky, and then next turn I guess we're gonna have to Shatter the Sky. Unfortunately. Yeah, he didn't fall for it. Well, we have to do it anyway. I mean, we have no cards, so it's basically game over. We definitely need to put Maze Mind Tome or something else to draw cards. Or probably Maze Mind Tome in this deck. Because now we're in a situation where we got nothing. Nothing. Please don't kill our angel. And of course they have removal spell because they have three cards in hand and it's the opponent. The opponent always has whatever they need against us. Always. Ha ha ha. Embercleave. How greedy is this deck, really? You're gonna be running like how many creatures and Embercleave? I mean, they definitely don't have that many creatures. Definitely. But they're gonna run Embercleave. I mean, they only play one creature besides these. That's just ridiculous. Okay, so I guess we're dead because, of course, opponent has Embercleave in a deck that probably runs only 10 creatures. 10 or 12 creatures. That makes a lot of sense. That makes a lot of sense. Okay, let's put the artifact in. That was directly the worst matchup we could have possibly had with this mono white deck. And of course the opponent had to get they got their cards because it's the opponent. We all know how that works. What is that mirror called? Something something mirror? No, it's not even a mirror. Why do we not remember these cards? Oh, Maze Mind Tome, it's a book. So let's take two of these guys out. Take this out. Actually, we don't need Elspeth. Let's put the Maul back in. Maul of the Skyclaves. Come on, Arena, get with the program. Okay, let's put this back in. And we have 22 creatures. Yeah, I mean, let's get it on. We got scry power now. We got card draw power. So hopefully we can get in and win something. I mean, we did play against that deck that looked like it's a competitive deck, although with them running Embercleave and probably 10 to 12 creatures in the deck, it's just one of those things. If it's red, Embercleave it, I suppose. That's how they make their decks. We're gonna keep this, and we have no first turn drop or second turn drops, but opponent is on Lurus. What is this, mono red? Oh no, it's gonna be red black again. No, it's cycling. You can't really beat cycling unless we get something to gain some life. This doesn't get lifelink. We can't use the apparition to get rid of this thing though. And then we can equip it with this to make it hit really hard. Ouch, ouch. Adding insult to injury. Well, there goes one guy. And we can attack, so we can gain one life back. Yeah, next turn we can equip it with this. Fortunately, it doesn't have lifelink. This is pretty useless against this deck. Come on, enough with all the highly competitive decks. Can we just catch a break and not play? Or can we draw a Shatter the Sky? Let's just jump block with this guy. Nope, no Shatter the Sky for us. We do, however, have this guy. Let's see if they want to block. I don't think they want to block with their fox. Yeah, we need to get our angel in play so we can start gaining life. This is useless because they have nothing that costs 3 mana, literally. I think everything is 1 or 2 mana. Yeah, it's going pretty good for them. I mean, they got the creatures out that they need to finish the job. And we are just not drawing any board wipes. We are just getting rammed every which way. Yeah, that's also not gonna do it. I mean, we can block for a long time. But we're not gaining any life, and we are basically one flame away, whatever it's called, from being burned to death. Yeah, we definitely Shatter the Sky in this matchup, which apparently we're not drawing because that would be too easy if we board wiped them 2 turns ago. Boring, boring, boring. Why is this deck like even played anymore? It's not even a competitive, we're like in friendly play. Boring. Yes, you have a 10-10 and a 6-6. Congratulations. Did they even draw that card to finish us off next turn, or they're just gonna ping us for one with this? Yeah, it's equal to amount of mana. Each mana deals 1 damage to the opponent. It's just fantastic. That's what it is. Super fantastic. Nope. No Shatter the Sky means we're just gonna concede this one. I mean, they had their fun, but there's absolutely no way we can win this. We need to Shatter the Sky 4 turns when they have 2 creatures out. Because especially the 1 damage thing just kills us. And we are playing lifelink. I mean, we could have tried to gain some life, but it's not gonna do anything. They're just gonna continue to cycle and ping us for 1 damage for every card they cycle. And then they're just gonna hit our face for like 20 damage. This is what happens when standard is stale. People don't even want to play ranked, and when you go to unranked to test new decks, you just play against competitive ranks, which people don't have the guts to play in ranked. But they still play the decks. I mean, this is not a new deck, both decks that we play. The Rakdos discard deck and then the cycling decks. It's not even close to being new. I mean, obviously, people are not even interested in trying new decks. Because, you know, why would they try new decks when they can just waste time and play the same deck until the end of January after the next set comes out, and then hopefully people will play new decks. But we're looking at another 2 months, almost, of this so-called standard format. It's just electrifying. What is this mismatch land? What? Is this oh, we don't need any of these guys. What are they playing? Is this rogues? Dimir rogues? Because, you know, why wouldn't we play against Dimir rogues? It's so fresh and so new. Oh, it looks like a control deck. There's like no rogues coming out yet. That is weird as hell. Anyway, if they have counter spells, then we're pretty much dead. They can just sit back and counter everything. Where's our tome? We put 4 of those Maze Mind tomes in, just so we can have stuff to draw extra cards. Because that could give us an advantage. I mean, we wouldn't lose as fast. And of course we don't draw the stupid books that we put in, even though we put 4 of them in. Let's see, is this gonna get counter? It doesn't get counter, it means they probably have extinction event. Okay. Sure. Now what? No extinction event? Oh, we got unlimited lands. Is this gonna get counter? We're gonna get to the point where we might actually cast this to make two angels for 7 mana. Now they can read the extinction event. Yeah, of course it's getting counter. Okay, so we're playing against Dimir Control. For some godforsaken reason. Mm-hmm. Just sit back and just counter everything. Okay. Let's try to play this guy instead. Is this gonna get counter? No. Okay, does this mean they have removal? Okay, no idea what's going on. I mean, if it's a control deck, it's a pretty damn slow control deck. Wait, what? They're just gonna block. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. We're gonna run this guy out even if they have extinction event next turn. I mean, it doesn't really matter. We are also 1 mana away from making 2 angels. But this is a 4, this is 5, so extinction event wouldn't do anything. Okay, that's just a mistake. Well, that could possibly cost them the game unless they have extinction event. Oh, this doesn't affect that. Okay, we just screwed up. This is, I forgot it's under 4 mana. Supposed to hold this back. Okay, we screwed up. We're supposed to Elspeth Conquer's Death this, not Skyclave Apparition. This is 4 mana and under. So if Elspeth Conquer's Death this when they tapped out, it would have been game over basically. Now I have to try it this time. No, we wouldn't do it for that. Anyway. I guess they have to take the 2 damage from the apparition. Because they have to block the other 2 things. That was a huge mistake. That was a huge mistake. If we SPF Conquers Death the enchantment instead of the apparition, it would have been game over. Because they were tapped out. That was a huge mistake. I mean, we still have a chance to win, I guess, if they don't kill our creatures next turn. Obviously. I mean, there are 3, even if they cycle 2 things, I mean, if they cast 2 instants to make 2 tokens, that might not be enough. But we totally screwed that one up. And also, we haven't drawn our tome. We did put the 4 books in, we have not drawn anything. Oh, interesting. They didn't want to return something to our hand. That's very weird. That is very weird. So all our guys have been indestructible until our next turn. Well, not our angels, but these other creatures. Wait, why don't the flyers? Oh, non-angel. Okay, she's an angel, so she doesn't get indestructible. What are they doing? They're just gonna take the 6 damage? They have to block the angel. Why would they not block the angel? They have a shark. They don't have demons or dragons. Okay, we have no idea how we won that one. The good news is we won, so the deck kind of works even without us throwing the tome and without us making a huge mistake with the Elspeth Concourse. This game could have been over a lot faster if we used the correct card to get rid of their Shike Typhoon. However, we'll go on and see if we can get another win with this deck. Hopefully we can get some people who play new decks and not competitive decks. Well, Arena heard us and we did get 2 books this time. With our luck, we might play against like mono red deck, against which this hand sucks. Or not. Another cycling deck, I guess. No idea what deck this is. Absolutely no idea. But looks like it's a relatively slow white deck. Why would they play this first? Oh, that's why. Because they want to pump it up. Well, let's hope this can draw us into a Shatter the Sky ASAP. Or this gets out of hand. So it's mono white aggro. It is mono white aggro. Yeah, we definitely need a Shatter the Sky ASAP. That's not it. We need to get Shatter the Sky on the 4th turn. We're gonna take massive amount of damage. And now we also have 1 drops and 2 drops and 3 drops. So we also need to get a 3 drop to be able to block if they don't kill it. If not, we're gonna get killed quite fast. Just by these 2 guys. Oh, they put it on this one. Okay, they want to diversify their assets. Doesn't really matter, the amount of damage is the same. That's a lot of damage by turn 3. Okay. Well, the good news is we got a blocker if they don't kill it. We also get to draw an extra card. Hopefully Shatter the Sky. No, it's another land, because why would we not draw unlimited lands? At least if they don't kill it, we get to block something and we also gain 1 life. That's not good at all. Yeah, we definitely Shatter the Sky against this deck. I mean, we could Elspeth Concourse deck the Lurus next time. We probably have to Elspeth Concourse after Lurus. If we don't Shatter. But I don't think that would even help us. Yeah. Okay. If we Elspeth, we still take 10 damage. Yeah, we're not winning this game, obviously. After drawing back-to-back planes, we didn't even draw another small creature. A 2-drop or a 3-drop, so we can at least have 2 blockers. We did not draw Shatter the Sky. We did not draw anything. Yeah, it's game over. I mean, there's nothing we can do. There is absolutely nothing we can do. I mean, one shatter would just basically wipe the whole board, and we have plenty of time to recover and restart. That was horrible, and they got to go first, because why wouldn't they get to go first? And why would we not top deck two lines in a row, two or three lines in a row, I think. After we kept a three-land hand, and we managed to scry one card to the bottom, and then we top deck more lands when we do not need lands. We need creatures. So let's go ahead to the next game and keep our fingers crossed again. And of course this deck was just made, we just put it together now. We're not expecting it to be hyper competitive, but at the same time, it should have game. I mean, we have the Apparitions at 3 mana, we have the Shatter the Skies, we have the Elspeth Conquers Deaths at 5 mana, and we have enough creatures, like 1 and 2 casting costs. Opponent gets to go first. We have nothing to play until turn 4. And the lands, they are coming. What on God's green earth are we playing against now? Yeah, like you can see, we're top decking lands, back-to-back lands again. I mean, it doesn't matter in this matchup because they're not even attacking us. It's been 3 turns and they haven't hit us once. But, I mean, against the other matchup that was aggro, this flooding, back-to-back drawing lands, like 3 lands in a row, is just ridiculous. It's like, yeah, you can try to win a game, but of course, you're not going to get to win the game. Yeah, another land, 4 lands, back-to-back-to-back. I mean, we're gonna cast this on curve on turn 7 at this point. But, like, 4 lands, really? Yes, you can kill it, of course, because why wouldn't you kill it? I mean, not like we're gonna be casting anything else. Well, that gives us something to Elspeth Conquers Death. And we can get our Mangara back. Yes, yes, yes. Congratulations. Congratulations. And of course you have another murderous rider, because why wouldn't you? You're the opponent. You have everything you need. Well, when we shatter the sky, they should be crying. Unfortunately, we're gonna get Mangara back too. Actually, we don't have to shatter the sky. We do not have to shatter the sky at all. We can just get rid of the Rust Rider. And pass the turn. What's going on now? You want to kill this angel again? Why are people taking so long? It's not that complicated. Okay, cast more creature. That's fine. Yeah, attack with the rats. Okay. We take the 1 damage. Whoop-de-doo. This is gone. This is coming into play. Sure. We'll take the 7 lamp to cast Emeria Squall next turn. Really? You're gonna go for the sacrificing the rat option? Yeah, but it does come back on our upkeep, and then we can take the Piper guy and whatever. I mean, they need to kill this angel, or I don't know what they need to do. Not gonna be pretty. Yeah, the apparition comes back, and then we take their Piper. They can forget about shenanigans. Shenanigans. Sure, you can have another rat. We cast this. We make two more angels. And then we attack with our angel in the air. And Bob's your uncle. Shebang. And shebang. Shazam. Yeah, we'll keep this. This is indestructible, so we're not even gonna worry about that. Yes, yes, that's how we do it. I mean, the deck, their deck did nothing until turn 4. They're attacking us with a 1-1 rat. Which was good, because we drew lands galore. Okay, let's try one last game. Let's hope to get our third win. That would be fantastic, as they say. A third win would be fantastic. Because, I mean, the deck should work. We don't get hit with the mana. The difficult mana situation. That would be good. Opponent goes first again, but I mean... we do have two Fable Passages, and we have second turn Tome. How did we get from like no... what is this? Okay, whatever. We got from no Maze Mind Tome to like two Maze Mind Tomes in our opening hands, like every game, some strange reason. Yeah, I will take Crawling Barrens. Is this mono black? Nobody knows, nobody cares. Let's get it working. Let us get it working. Yeah, we'll keep him. Simulacru, Does this work on Simulacru? Yeah, it does. Alrighty then. Let's get the apparition. Let's Simulacru. Let's Simulacru. Bye bye. Hello? There's no hello here. There's only a bunch of Maze Mind Tome. And let's pass. Hello. Two, 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 two. Oh, it's this type of deck. Okay. Hello. This time we're not making the same mistake again. Yeah, not making the same mistake again. Don't need another planes, I think. Is it you I'm looking for? Oops. We screwed that one up royally. We screwed that one up royally. I mean, they are ramping slowly to Ugin. They're one land away from Ugin. There's not much you can do about that. I mean, they got three or four Solemn. They got like three Solemn Simulacrum. This should have been even. We screwed that one up too, but I mean, I guess we have to Shatter the Sky next turn anyway. Or do we? I guess we don't. Okay. That's interesting. But it's good to know they have Heartless Act. Yeah, that's unfortunate for us. That's a lot of books. That is a lot of books. So we don't need this and we don't need this. For the love of God, enough with the Shatter the Skies. We use two books. We use our two books. They still somehow have a lot more cards than us. They got their one Ugin out. Yeah, it's time to Elspeth him. Get the book out. I mean, they can probably draw into another one. And there you have it. Back to back Ugins, because why wouldn't they have? They are the opponent. Why would they not have back to back Ugins? Oh, we get to keep our book. That's not bad. Wait a second. We can make this into a creature. And kill their Ugin? I think so. Yeah, let's go to attack step. Yeah, they only have one mana. They only have one mana and there's nothing to kill. Okay, we kill back to back Ugin. We don't feel so bad now. Yeah, we'll take another crawling baron. Do they have third Ugin? Back to back Ugin? No, okay. That's a lot of books. That is a lot of books they got there. That's a lot of card draw. Oh, that's good they killed that because we're gonna shatter the sky anyway. I mean, they're gonna get to draw a card, but there's not much we can do about it. So I set fire to the rain. I mean, there's nothing we can do about it. They could probably draw another again, but we draw all our books. All four books, they drew all their books. Everyone's booking it like crazy. What kind of a crazy combo is this, my friend? What kind of a crazy combo is this? Yeah, no idea what we're gonna do here. Just draw a bunch of cards, I guess. Probably a land at this point. This guy does have trample. Are we gonna draw a land? No. Okay, that's not bad. We can Elspeth him if they don't cast another crazy Ugin. They do cast two of them. Okay, we can't Elspeth him because of course they have Agonizing Remorse. Because why wouldn't they have Agonizing Remorse? It's the opponent. Okay, we're not gonna block anyway. That was interesting. This has trample, so we need to figure out another way of killing it. We need another Elspeth or another Shatter the Sky. That's neither of those. But we need to gain some life as well. Okay, there. Yeah, we can block with this guy, gain 2 life, get a token. Draw another card. Enough with the plains already. That's already 2 lands again, back to back lands. Yeah, so we need to draw something and then top deck something else, or I don't know what we need to do to survive after the next turn. We need to kill this troll, obviously. Mono black versus mono white, the eternal struggle. Okay, well, that saves us the trouble of even Oh, they have crawling barons too. How fancy is that? How did they even get to 29 life? Please don't kill our angels. I mean, we have to double block, but they probably have another one of these. They also have more card draw, because they have Castle Lochthwain. So we're basically out of card draw. We use all four books. Just attack, and then we double block. Or you can just win, of course, because why wouldn't we? When we play Extinction Event, we have no chance, but when the opponent plays it, of course they get it every single time. Well, there you have it. Mono white in standard. Kind of mid range, but absolutely no chance of winning anything. So we tried it. And this is the result. Thank you for watching. Please click like and subscribe for more daily MTG content videos.